Hi, I am Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram, consultant neonatologist and pediatrician. Welcome to my channel again. And as we discussed, we will be having a series of videos on certain aspects of breast milk and breastfeeding. And in the previous video, we looked at evolution of breastfeeding, which was a unique topic. And in this video, we'll be looking at the composition of breast milk as an overview. In the consequent presentations, we'll be looking at specific aspects like protein in breast milk, lactose in breast milk, and so on. So, breast milk is a perfect orchestra of components which is produced by an active process. It's designed to support and nourish the infant. The breast milk contains a variety of bioactive agents that modify the function of the gastrointestinal tract, the immune system, as well as in brain development. When we say bioactive, these are proteins, for example, which have immune functions. There may be hormone-like functions where they affect the baby's satiety regulation, appetite control, and so on as well. So the World Health Organization recommends that infants should be exclusively breastfed for the first 6 months of life, and we should continue for as long as possible after that also, along with the other foods, weaning foods. Breastfeeding is convenient and inexpensive. It's also a bonding experience, and we discussed in the previous video, it's a signaling tool between the mother and the baby to resolve various conflicts that may exist between them. Breastfeeding rates are variable, and exclusive breastfeeding rates drop over time due to various factors. So because of the multiple advantages of breastfeeding, we should do our best to support exclusive breastfeeding. And the benefits for the child include protection against gastrointestinal respiratory infection. There is a reduced risk of allergy. The longer term benefits are more important. There is a reduced or lower incidence of obesity and diabetes. This might be related to the effect on the gut microbiota, and the appetite regulation. Overfeeding is much lower with breastfeeding compared to formula feeding. I would recommend you to watch my video on probiotics and cesarean sections to get a better idea of how gut microbiota influences. There's a lower level of cholesterol and blood pressure in the breastfed babies, and at least in the initial year or so, there is a higher performance in the intelligence tests in the breastfeeding babies. Composition of breast milk, it's a complex matrix, mainly water. We have close to 4% of fat, 7% of lactose, and 1% of protein. We have an interesting group called the human milk oligosaccharides, which is the third largest constituent with 1.2 to 1.5%. These have no nutritional value, but they have very important immune value, as we will discuss in the presentation on HMOs. The fat and the lactose respectively provide 50% and 40%. So you can see that fat is lower in content, but provide more energy because fat is more energy dense. And the lactose provides 40% of the total energy. So this ratio is different when we come to other animal milks. So this is split up, again reflecting the same point that I mentioned earlier. So fat 30 to 50 gram per liter, lactose is 50 to 60 grams, protein is 8 to 10 grams per liter, and human milk oligosaccharide is a third component, 10 to 12 grams per liter. The composition of breast milk is dynamic and it changes over time, adapting to the changing needs of the growing milk. There are some components, the bioactive components, hormonal factors, neurotransmitters, which come through at each stage. Even during the daytime and the nighttime, there may be differences. For example, the milk that the mother produces at bedtime has been shown to have more serotonin, and this has an effect on baby sleep as well. The important part to remember here is that the foremilk, which is thinner and has higher lactose, and the hind milk, which is thicker and has more fat, nature has produced it in a balance. So as the baby starts during the initial phase, they are thirsty and hungry, and they are satisfied quickly with this milk. And then as the feed progresses, they get the thicker, more fatty milk, which gets them to sleep after that. And during early lactation, the protein content in the human milk ranges from 1.4 to 1.6 grams per 100 ml. This reduces as the baby grows to 0.8 to 1 gram per 100 ml because the volume of milk is increasing as the baby grows. And after 6 months, it reduces to 0.7 to 0.8 grams. And this is nature's way, because we have already started complementary feeding, the baby can start getting more independent. So the way nature progresses is to reduce the protein And that's why we should be careful when we give formula feeding for the baby, because the protein content doesn't change much. In fact, in the follow-on milks, it's more. So we shouldn't increase the volume of the milk as the baby grows. We should give more complementary feeds and reduce the milk as they grow. In the next video, we will discuss the protein components in the breast milk as well as the fat. I hope this is useful to you, and do subscribe, do turn notifications on, and do share. Thank you for watching.